Good morning, friends. This is a video which discusses the intraday play for Monday. I think that is 11th of January 2021. Now, you know, one market view is the market is going up. So that is very easy to give. Why? Because on a net basis, the market is going up. But what do you do on Monday? Because let me tell you what the problem is after we've seen the S&P 500 chart. S&P 500 chart yesterday on Friday, after spending some time at lower levels, has again given you a bullish upside, and that would mean for the SGX Nifty. In fact, SGX Nifty has closed at 11,440,488. That is going to be like a 110-point gap up. Now, the issue is, what do we do after the gap up? Well, before that, let me give you some messages that you can join our platinum button for a great amount of live trading with me, plus trading psychology, money management. And, you know, its superiority can only be appreciated by people who are in it, because you know, just the calls are difficult because of market volatility, and you know, the way you know, trades need to be managed real time. For people who want to take lower level services, they are also available as diamond, gold, silver, etc. These having different perks. You can join them through the YouTube channel. Also, we have a recorded webinar which is available for 2000 plus GST. Again, for questions, WhatsApp 98710-66337. Email ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. That is ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. For free engagement with us, you can join us through our Facebook group, Ashwani Gujral Followers. Also, my business page, Ashwani Gujral. We are having at the moment two lives on Facebook through the business page, and one live will happen tomorrow on YouTube at 5 p.m. The Facebook live timings are Tuesday and Friday, 8 p.m. each. We will probably be reducing that Facebook live to once a week, and hopefully I can meet with some of you, and those would be you know, places where engagement is not available at a cost. Also, on Facebook followers, I do give hints on my insights and my thinking of the market. So if you visit that on a daily basis, you will pick up some nuggets. Okay, that being said, now let's get back to the Nifty. Nifty had a very strong move on Friday, and we had said that if we start to trade above 14,250, you will get a gap up and you will get follow through, and we got our follow through. Okay. And this was about a 200 point move. Now, if we look at the last few days, Nifty opens, gap up, comes down. Again, this day, we open, gap up, come down during the day. Okay. So most of these gap ups have been sold into. Gap up, sell off. So the problem here is that either you take home positions, gap up, sell off, and you use these gap ups to take profits. But on Monday, what is likely is you have this 150-200 point rally of Friday, plus you are likely to open around these levels. This is 488. So the odds of the market slipping and almost having an intraday collapse are very high. So this is not a buy trade. In fact, this would be, according to me, a 5-star sell trade. But how do you sell? Say the market gaps up, and after a gap up, it is hanging around here, and then we start to collapse. The other way is that you open gap up and the first candle is red. In this scenario, the first candle is green. So first candle is red, and after that, at some point, you get a bit of consolidation, and then the market starts a decline. But both of these patterns have very high odds of working on Monday. I know there is good news on TCS, and even that will gap up. But a lot of the good news is priced in from Friday. The other trade is that once the collapse happens and you come down somewhere near the pivot for Monday is about 14,310. So that would be your first port of call here, or above that, if we want to see, because the market is in such a strong trend, the R1 for Monday is 14,492. So chances are that you could get a 150-200 point collapse, because 14,500 is the upper end of the range. So I don't think there is a support above this zone. But remember, what is the trigger? The trigger would be some sort of 15-minute low or basically you wait for the upside to end and you mark the low of the day for the first 15 minutes. Now, sometimes what can happen is that you collapse in this manner. In that case, you have to wait for some sort of a consolidation type of upside, and then you take your position. But this is the sort of day where in the money options can be taken on the put side. Plus, once the trade starts to work, you can also add. So this is as far as the Nifty is concerned. Now the other theory I have is about the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty at the end of everything may turn out to be the stronger index at the end of Monday. Why? Because it has already consolidated on Friday. So you make this sort of a box on the 5-minute on Bank Nifty, and Bank Nifty could actually show you more follow through than the Nifty on Friday. We have seen that on Friday, Nifty went up, but Bank Nifty came off. So this sort of dichotomy can continue. What I expect is that once, you know, the Nifty opens gap up and then it comes down, the Bank Nifty will come down less, and after the collapse, when the Nifty starts to recover, the Bank Nifty will recover more than the Nifty. The idea here is that anybody who bought on Friday is sitting on a 300 point profit Monday morning. So chances are that those guys will come in to take profits. Even if Asian markets, etc., are higher, I think at some point on Monday, you will have some kind of intraday collapse. Now, what does it mean for stocks? On stocks, what that can mean is that you have a first green bar, and immediately stocks start to make lows of the day even after the first 5 minutes. So that will indicate to you that where weakness is coming in. Okay. So very important to see what sort of stocks start giving up ground immediately after the start. I have not mentioned the word buy at all, because the buy trade is out Monday morning. The buy trade will happen once there is a strong wave of profit booking and the market collapses towards its equilibrium zone, which I think could be somewhere near 14,350-400. Let's see if we can figure out that zone on the See, somewhere in this area, this is about 14,340. So it is possible that you open here and you collapse towards this zone, and that is where you find support. But particularly on large heavyweights, and you know the way techs are expected to open, it looks very unlikely that technology stocks could continue their upside on an intraday basis. Yes, they will go up over the next 5 years or so. TCS had a nice up move. Infosys has had a nice up move. And again, if they open up a further gap up, then you have to see what happens from there. The, you know, financials, I think financials are already quite beaten up. So there could be a bit of rotation in financials. That is the expectation, because financial did not have a similar rally on Friday. So my sense is that you gap up, you have a collapse, and then post the collapse, you know, money moves into financials. So that is the sort of intraday trade plan that you have and you should have for many days, because follow through after a gap up happened in November. And now, basically, if you gap down, you have a buy trade. If you open at or near yesterday's close, then you look for price action. And if you have these large gap ups, see here you had gap ups and the market continued up. This is also ICICI Bank, but even if you look at Nifty, there is a time for the market to gap up and go up, gap up, go up. But most of the time, this is how gap ups end up. The gap down often gives you much more money on the upside than a gap up. See, this is a gap up which continued on the upside. This is a phase in the market. This happens maybe 10% of the time. Most of the time, the gap up is sold into, the gap down is bought. Gap up, sell off. So in this sort of a market, you have to be mentally prepared on how to deal with these monster gap ups, particularly after a strong up day in the previous session. I would think all sorts of stocks, financials, techs included, the first 15 minute breakdown should offer you a nice opportunity to sell on Monday. This is an intraday sell because of the excesses which may happen Monday morning. So that's it in terms of strategy, and be careful, take your own decisions, consult your financial advisor, like, share, subscribe, and we'll see you in another video.